killing people. How y'all doing? Ah! Oh man, it's hot. Today has been a great day. Like, work was great. Didn't really do much. We're still working on the same warehouse we've been doing. But yeah. Work is always, man, I ain't never complaining for work, dude. Work is so easy. You paint, you slide the brush in between the cracks, you wash them lines, get all smooth and doobie, and that's it. The only minus to that is you and the sun. Cause the sun starts like in the morning, you get there like 5-6 in the morning, right? It's all shadow. And throughout the day, when that shadow starts disappearing like vampires, you gotta stay out the sun, stay out the sun. I got a farmer's tan, man. Not that dark. I look like a normal caramel mocha latte. Now I look like a premium black coffee roast from Dunkin' Donuts. I'm on the way to the high school to go wrestle Adrian Collier, a future national champ for the University of Dubuque. Ah! My ex-teammate from Zion Benton. Oh man, I miss those days. Zion wrestling, man. Anybody that's been on the Zion wrestling team, it's just, there's a bond between the wrestlers, man, that you would never break. It's crazy. But yeah, I'm finna go wrestle Adrian. I'm dead, dude. I've been out in the sun all day. I've been burning. I've been tanning. I'm tan. I'm hungry. Even though I had pork chops, a brat, and a piece of steak for lunch at work. But I'm still hungry, man. When you're in the sun, that stuff be burning through me like sandpaper real quick. I don't know how I'll be sandpaper, but I'm just saying.
Oh, Lord. Hey.
So we finna get the wrestling. Then after I finish, going to see my girl, my missus. I love that girl. Look at my... Whole bunch of ZBs and a future. I mean, returning ZB is back in town, buddy.
Let's go upstairs.
Oh, upstairs. Oh, unlock the front door then.
It's already unlocked.
No, it's not. It's locked. The main entrance is locked.
Okay, hold on. I'm coming down.
Look at him. Look at Mr. Lusford. A haircut.
You gotta hold it down.
I can't. I'm great. How about
you? What are you doing at school?
I'm doing two classes at CLC.
Oh, that's right. Dude,
so it starts in the 24th. Okay. And then I should be all set and I'll be back at school in the spring.
Okay, good. Go work out.
All right. That's Mr. Lunsford. Man, Lunsford is a crazy. Look what we got here. Hey, what's up, man? Cuz I'm videotaping stuff.
Okay.
Man, what's up? How you
going on? What's going on?
Oh, dude, I'm fucking. I'm like burning.
Burning from what?
Huh? I've been out in the sun all day painting.
Oh yeah, you're all in Romeoville?
Yeah.
Oh, that's far.
Yeah, I know. That's when we leave at like 4 in the morning.
They have you guys commute?
Huh?
They have you guys commute? Like, you take like a truck that they give you, or you have to use your own car?
No, we meet at Gurnee and then go in the big truck, and we all go out there. Okay. I'm baking, dude. I got a farmer's tan. Look at that. That don't even make sense.
Farmer's tan. Black man with farmer's tan.
That's what I just said. Yeah. So I just seen Lunsford, and now we back. Oh, look at that! Oh, I got it. Oh, hold on, I gotta see that in a minute. But back in the factory, look at this—the biggest mat room in the conference, the best mat room in the conference. Look who that is, Adrian Collier, Little Ears Collier.
Little Ears.
Man, look at him. He all Dubuque'd out. He got the Inflix. Ooh! He got the Nike socks. Ooh! Dubuque shorts. Oh! Got the Dubuque Lightning Spartan shirt. Oh! The Dubuque headgear.
go! Where champions are made.
Champions are made, man. Watch. D3 national champion is going to be here. He's focused. Focused. Dedicated. He hungry. I mean hungry like you wake up at 6 in the morning but realize there's no toast strudel or Eggo waffles, so then you got to get some plain oatmeal and put some milk in it and eat it raw. That's the type of hungry he is right now. Mm-hmm. Look at him. Look at the dude, babe. Tell him. Tell him. Tell him.
Just look tell out him why. This year.
Tell him why you're going to win this national title.
I want to win this national title so I can put Zion back on the map. I want to show them that we can produce top athletes in the state, let alone this nation, and eventually the world. Can't wait.
There you go. This is a pre-interview before he won the national title. So I already got the interview, premium press, so y'all get out of here. I already got it first. I'm going to get paid. Ah, I ain't going to get paid. But man, look at him. And the thing is, what's crazy, high school, right? You know, everybody go to IHSA state and place and do all this. Adrian didn't go to state. Didn't even make past regionals. Got sugar shot. But the difference between that now, is his hard work, man. Because even though he didn't do anything in high school, everybody do us. I did. I went to state 2 times in a row in high school. But I'm not wrestling in college yet, but I probably will. Just wait. I'm going to wrestle. I'm going to surprise everybody.
That's another one. Wait for that to happen.
But, dude, on his way to a national title, and he's going to get it. I know he's going to get it. But it's crazy. So from somebody that didn't do anything in high school to pre-preparation for this national title, it's going to be crazy. And you know what the crazy thing is? You're going to be like a celebrity because I can say I just wrestled with the national champion right now because I'm about to wrestle. I'm about to wrestle. But look, oh, man, this is going to be great. I'm telling you, watch. Watch him, and everybody going to be, oh, Adrian, you this and you that. Like, no, I know I was here when he was working hard. You were. Don't hop on the bandwagon because the bandwagon going to tip you over. Mm. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Here we go. We get it started. Let me see everyone doing the winners.
For real? Damn!
You kept saying one more.
I know.
One split.
He got one more. He got one more, people. He got one more. One more. Adrian Collier and a three-time NCAA champ. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? I do. You feel great?
Yeah.
You feel great?
Yeah.
Yeah. Put some foot on my time.
Yep. Yeah,
see, that's what I like doing. I like pushing people.
Thanks, Nick.
You're welcome. How you feel?
That feels good.
You feel like a...
Feels good. It sucks, but it feels good after you push your limits.
You feel like a national champ.
I feel like I'm going to be... MVP at the national tournament.
Yes, sir. Yee. Oh, I need a cheese and a hot plate right now.
Ready.
He's ready. Jesus. It's been a while since I wrestled. I'm a little sloppy. Sloppy. But don't get me twisted. I might sneak up on you.
Yeah.
The singlet on too.
Yeah.
Oh man, I love wrestling, man. Even though my main sport is football.
The hardest sport around. Wrestling is the hardest sport around.
Hardest sport around. But track. Ooh, track is a whole nother story. But wrestling, you know, it's the toughest sport. Until I ran track. Jesus, I was dying like crazy. Talking about, God, wrestling's still the hardest sport? I was laying on the track, I'm like, nope. Well, both sports is hard on different levels. Yeah. But both sports are still the toughest sport around, and swimming. Oh my God, dude, I can't swim. I mean, I can swim, I can't swim long. Like, I can swim to survive and not get killed. But I can't swim to just be doing it. I got too much muscle. I be swimming, people be like, float. I'm floating, I be, I can't keep myself up. That's where all them fat people, they be floating easy, they be. I can't float like that.
I woke up like this.
Hey.
I wish I did the track, I'd be.
Woo hoo hoo. But yep, I know I'm getting beat up right now, but it's cool. I like live wrestling, man. When I was in high school, I hate when we drilled. Coach be like, drill this, drill that. I'd be like, no. I ain't never tell him no, he crazy. I ain't gonna tell him no. But I feel if you wrestle live, that is your drilling because you're not gonna, okay, I can sit here and, oh, come here. Let me high crotch duck under you. They ain't gonna let you do that in the match. So if you practice live and do it 100%, 100% fast, when you get in the match, it's gonna be, that's gonna be your drilling because you already did this 60, 80 plus times in the mat room. Oh, he like.
It does take a lot of repetition. You have to do a lot of repetition for whatever thing you're gonna do. So that's where drilling can also just definitely help you, you know, break it down, slow it down, and actually get the technique down. But yeah, Nick's right too with the whole live. Live, you're gonna get a good feel for it, but drilling, you can perfect technique more.
Perfection. But me, I'm just a weird dude. I got a weird style of wrestling. I just like going live. I wish every practice I can just go live every practice. I love doing that.
And you did not get tired.
No, not at all. That's how you win matches. You got insane cardio, like more. You win all matches. I beat so many people, big people. Now granted, I wrestled 170 junior and senior year when I was only 164. I was like, you know what? I ain't cutting weight no more. Forget that. So at weigh-in, I was eating food at weigh-ins. Like, I was eating sandwiches and looking at people like, because they can't eat. I'm like, well, I'm on a scale. What'd it say? 168. I'm still underweight. Man, but yeah, I just like going live. I wish I can get paid to go live with wrestlers, dude. I would sit there and wrestle live all day with somebody. Adrian. And Martin, too. I wrestle live with Adrian. Adrian gets tired. Okay, I ain't saying he not out of shape. But when I wrestle, I don't get tired. So I can just go. You can just call me up like you did now. I was at work, get ready to go chill. And my girlfriend, he's like, hey, you want to wrestle? Okay, I go wrestle. And I can do this all day. You know how people spar boxing to get paid to get beat up? I want to get paid to wrestle people. Mm-hmm.